I hear the drums echoing tonight. She hears only whispers of some quiet conversation. She's coming in 12:30 flight. Moonlit wings reflect the stars that guide you towards salvation. I stopped an old man along the way, hoping to find some old forgotten words or ancient melodies.
Florida Foundation Phase, Miss Morgan here. I am really excited to talk to you about today's assembly. We are going to be learning about Isra and Miraj. These are known as the Prophet's Night Journey and Ascension. So to get us started, we are going to take a moment and think about the reasons why people might pray. You may like to pause the video for a moment, teachers, and discuss this with your class. Why do you think people may pray? Prayer is really important to Muslims. Most Muslims pray 5 times a day. They stop what they are doing and use this as an opportunity to talk to God. Reasons why Muslims may pray include talking to God, listening to God, asking for help, saying sorry, and giving thanks, saying thank you to God. Now, they pray 5 times a day, at the beginning of the day, in the middle of the day, in the late afternoon, in the evening, and last thing at night. These 5 daily prayers are known as Salat. Before prayer, Muslims wash carefully as a way of being ready to pray and showing respect to God. Each time they pray, wherever they are in the world, they face towards Mecca, which is one of the most special and holiest places in the world. Now, the reason, or one of the reasons why prayer is so important to Muslims and adhering to Salat, the praying 5 times a day, is because of a story relating to the Prophet Muhammad. So, let me tell you the story. Muslims believe that God sent many messengers or prophets to earth to tell people about God and how he wanted them to live. The last messenger was the Prophet Muhammad. He is considered the most important messenger, and because of this, Muslims give him great honour. They say a blessing after his name, peace be upon him. It was the Prophet who told them of God's command to pray 5 times a day. At this time of year, Muslims think about the story of where that command came from. And it's the story of the Prophet's night journey and ascension. A very long time ago, nearly 1,400 years ago, the Prophet Muhammad was living in Mecca, which is in the country we now call Saudi Arabia. It was a difficult and sad time for him. People would not listen to what he said about God. They were angry with him and hostile towards him. But one night, something wonderful happened. The Prophet was woken by an angel who took him on an amazing journey. It seemed that he travelled on a mysterious animal, rather like a horse with wings. And I've included a picture of what that animal may have looked like for you to look at too. When the journey was finished, the Prophet had arrived in Jerusalem. Muslims call this journey Al-Isra, the night journey. It's why Jerusalem is a very special place for Muslims. This wasn't the end of the journey, because then the angel took the Prophet from Jerusalem on a journey to heaven. This part of the journey is called Al-Miraj, the ascension. On the second part of the journey, the Prophet passed through the 7 heavens, where he met other prophets. And finally, he met with God. It was a wonderful meeting that seemed to happen in an instant. Now the Prophet knew that God would help and guide him in the difficult time ahead. And then God commanded him to tell people about the importance of prayer. It was a way in which they could communicate with God and that they should pray 5 times a day. The Prophet returned home, having learned many things, feeling hopeful and more able to deal with the hostility he met from those who were against him. Now, Jerusalem is a holy city for 2 other religions, I wonder, pause the video, which religions do you think they may be? I wonder if you collected, if you discussed the two other religions. So we've got Islam, Judaism, and Christianity. Diane, if you got the extra two. The place in Jerusalem from which the prophet began the second part of the journey to heaven can still be seen today. It is called the Dome of the Rock. And lots of people visit there as a very special and holy place. Take a moment and have a little think about the story. Why did the prophet feel close to God? What did God tell the prophet that prayer was? And how many times a day do Muslims pray? I really enjoyed learning about Isra and Miraj and finding out more about it, and I really hope that you have too. Prayer is such an important part of spirituality and a really, really important part of Islam, and hopefully you've learned a little bit more about that too. Now, to play us out at the end of today's assembly, I will be playing our song of the week, which is Toto, Africa. I hope you enjoy. Double key.
Echoing tonight, she hears only whispers of some quiet conversation. She's coming in 12:30 flight. Moonlit wings reflect the stars that guide her toward salvation. I stopped an old man along the way, hoping to find some old forgotten words or ancient melodies. He turned to me as if to say, "Hurry, boy, it's waiting there for you. Gotta take the life to take me away from you. There's nothing that I've